Good evening. We're so glad you're here for our elementary instrumental Christmas concert and followed by our fourth grade musical. This is our elementary orchestra. These are fourth and fifth graders who've been playing for 2 or 3 years. And this is really an exciting time, I think, in their orchestra journey because they're transitioning from just playing together at all to playing together in unison. And then as our next few pieces, you'll see multiple parts. So I've really been proud of them for how hard they've worked to get these next three together. The next one is Good King Wenceslas, and then the First Noel, and followed up with Jingle Bells. So I hope you enjoy the rest.
Thank you. is our fifth grade band. We're small, but we're mighty. Our next piece is a children's Christmas carol. And the words are, O come, little children, O come, one and all, to Bethlehem, haste, to the manger so small. God's Son for a gift has been sent you this night to be your Redeemer, your joy and delight. A children's Christmas carol, or O come, little children. Our next song is a little bit like a box of chocolates. It's going to be a sampler. And you're going to hear in it six songs, six Christmas carols, and little bits of them, just like you've taken a bite of that chocolate and put it back, which we used to do, but my dad was okay with that. It's going to start with just part of O Come All Ye Faithful, just the ending of it. And then I think it's Jolly Old St. Nicholas. You'll hear Jingle Bells. You'll hear the song we just played, O Come Little Children, the Children's Christmas Carol. You'll hear a little bit of Deck the Halls and Good King Wenceslas. I think I got them all. Did I get them all? I think I got them all. This is a holiday sampler. I need to tell you that half of these children up here just started this year. They just started in September. I think they're doing an amazing job. Remember, we all started this way. all of the us that are all of us that are musicians now, we all started the same way. Our last song for you is We Wish You a Merry Christmas, and we do. We wish you a Merry Christmas.
This is our fifth grade ORF ensemble, and they give up one of their recesses every week for about 20 minutes or so. Every week we work on some arrangements together. It's just kind of a fun time to give them a little playing experience outside of general music class. We're going to be playing Carol of the Bells for you, and ORF is all about patterns and finding those patterns, how we can layer them, and Carol of the Bells is a whole big giant song full of patterns. So they worked really hard on this, and to remember it all, they've done a great job. So I hope you enjoy Carol of the Bells.
Thank you. one, two, check, one, two.
Test 1, 2, check 1, 2.
Okay.
Two. Check 1, 2, test 1, 2. Check 1, 2, test 1, 2.
Test 1, 2, check 1, 2.
Test
1, 2, check 1, 2.
One more time.
Check 1, 2, test 1, 2.
One more time, I promise. This should be the last one.
Check 1, 2, test 1, 2. Check 1, 2, test 1, 2.
One more time.
Check 1, 2, test 1, 2.
Check
1, 2, test 1, 2.
Check 1, 2, test 1, 2.
Great.
Good evening. You guys are so quiet. It's great. My name is Laura Landis, and I am really excited to be able to help present to you tonight the fourth grade musical. I have the privilege of teaching these kiddos, and we've put together a musical for you called Crazy, Busy, Peaceful, Holy Night. It's a lot to swallow, that title, but hopefully you'll understand what that means. And if you're anything like me, you'll be able to relate this time of year. So we hope that you enjoy Crazy, Busy, Peaceful, Holy Night.
I'll be in a minute. I've got to get these cookies done. Okay, I have about 40 seconds until this batch of cookies is done. This is a problem, and I have 15 more to do, and I just finished my study guide. Well, sweetie, it sounds like you're making good progress. Here, you need to carry the one and then regroup. Oh, I've got to get those.
Honey, I'm home.
Dad, I really need help on this. Hey, honey, glad you're home. How was your day?
Dad, I really need help.
Okay, okay. It was good, except that now I have another interview for this promotion tomorrow, and we have the Christmas office party coming up. Okay, honey, let's see. You need to carry the ones and then regroup. Oh, son, you've got to play that correctly.
I can't find
find it. I just can't find it. I really need to find my halo before we go. Hey, Mom, I can't find my halo, and we need to hurry, or we're going to be late for the practice. I'll be in the car. I almost forgot. She has rehearsal for the Christmas musical. Any chance you could take her? I've got to get these cookies done.
Okay. I'll drop her off, and then I'll go get a little shopping. I've got a few more gifts to buy.
Oh, and while you're out, could you get a gift for the gift exchange, please? Just not a fruitcake. Keep practicing, buddy. You can get it.
Okay, nativity scene. Everyone, get in your places. Don't block the angels. Angels? Is that all the angels?
Sorry, I'm late.
Joseph, Mary, where are the sheep?
They're eating the manger straw.
Yeah, they've been bad.
Ugh. And where are the wise men?
There was an accident.
What do you mean, an accident?
Well, let's just say it looks like the wise men are only bringing gold and frankincense to the baby Jesus.
Where's the myrrh?
There. And there. And there.
What a crazy night.
These are finally cool enough to decorate. Can you help me decorate these? You're so good at that.
Oh, I love decorating cookies with you. Okay, I can take a little break from studying.
Justin, would you like to help?
Success! I made it through the mall and found almost everything else we need. And I even found a fruit cake.
It's Christmas, the bells are ringing. So glad you're home. You guys can help decorate. How was choir rehearsal, Julie? Are you guys almost ready for the Christmas musical?
Well, we will be. The wise men had a problem spilling their gifts, and the shepherds have lost their sheep. But at least Mary didn't drop Jesus this time.
Your choir director has so much more patience than I ever would have. I don't know how she does it. Jessica, did you finish your homework?
Almost. One of my problems is a survey. Could you answer a question for me? It's easy. What is the best part of Christmas?
Well, that's an easy one.
Presents!
What?
Cookies!
No!
Decorations!
Seriously?
Okay.
Maybe someone else could answer.
Hey, guys.
Dad, what's your answer?
Hello, guys.
Well, I love Christmas. We have the chance.
Hello, guys. Listen, it's carolers.
Like the narrow lane down, sing. Love.
some of my very favorite songs.
I know, mine too.
I love those songs.
I'm so glad they came. Hey, what happened here?
What do you mean?
What happened to what?
The nativity. Everything is knocked over.
Ah, man. It sure is.
I must have hit the table while I was running around getting the cookies ready.
I wasn't even paying attention when I came in with all my school books.
Or maybe I hit it with the shopping bags.
I don't think any of us would be paying attention. It's been crazy busy around here.
Mary and Joseph had to travel a long way to Bethlehem.
Even farther we go to Grandma's house?
Yes, even farther. And they had to walk.
And Mary was expecting a baby.
And then when they got there, it was so busy in town that they didn't even have a place to stay.
And what about the shepherds? They're working that day. It's a really smelly job.
Even stickier than Justin's shoes?
Hey! I bet those shepherds were scared out of their minds when they started hearing the angels sing. Can you even imagine?
I bet it was beautiful and loud and crazy.
I wonder what it was really like that night in Bethlehem, the very first Christmas.
The highest hallelujah.
Hallelujah. birth of Jesus, Luke 2, verses 1 through 20. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken over the entire Roman world, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David.
He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. As they were there, the time came for the baby to be born. She gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for him.
And the shepherds were living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. Then an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. And the shepherds were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths, lying in a manger."
Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with angels, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and peace on earth to whom his favor rests."
When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about."
So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they saw him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them.
But Mary treasured up all of these things, and she pondered them in her heart. For the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for what they had just seen and heard.
That night was possibly crazier and busier than we get here and now.
Traveling, fighting the crowds, singing, giving gifts.
Then and now.
But the perfect gift was given for us that night.
Love was born that first Christmas.
Crazy and busy became peaceful and holy.
God gave his son Jesus so we can have peace, even when we're busy.
But peace doesn't mean calm and quiet. That first night wasn't calm, and it sure wasn't quiet.
The shepherds were scared. The crowds were crazy. The angel singing was loud.
But it sure was peaceful because the Prince of Peace was born that night.
Jesus brings peace into a crazy, busy world.
Because we know we are loved no matter what.
We've been given the perfect gift, Jesus.
Christmas is crazy.
Christmas is busy.
Christmas is peaceful.
Christmas is holy.
Christmas is Jesus.
Through the crowds, no room in the inn.
Well, thank you, fourth graders, for really giving us a wonderful challenge to think about the crazy and the busy and the peaceful and the holy. I especially enjoyed helping us think about what peaceful might really look like, even when it's loud. So thank you for challenging us. Thank you to all of our music teachers, Mrs. Landis, Mrs. Lutzenberger, and Mrs. Berg. Thank you for your work. We love how you work with our children and help them learn music and more. We also want to thank all the classroom teachers, Mrs. Nelson, Ms. Glass, and Mr. Sprunger, and Mrs. Roth, and we could go on and on. Thank you to all the teachers for your work as well. Thank you. Fourth graders, take one more bow. Woohoo! All right. We're so glad that you could join us this evening. Would you bow your heads in prayer with me? Lord, we thank you for this Christmas season, for the baby Jesus that came, for the joy that he brought to the world, and for the peace. And we just ask that we go in peace this evening. In your name we pray. Amen. Please drive safely. Mrs. Landis has a few announcements.
I just want to make a quick announcement to fourth grade parents. You guys can have a seat. We're doing this tomorrow in chapel again, so I would like costumes that were here to stay here, but they should find you right now and check in, and if you would walk with them to wherever they're going, that would be great. Thank you so much. Have a great night.